Hey everyone, it's Gary the Google Guy here, and I've got a really important Gmail update for some of you, at least most of those people that are former Outlook users especially. And that is the new update with the feature of the ability to send an email as an attachment in another Gmail. So we have a couple of different things that we can do here. First off, in the old way of doing things with Google Mail, to add an email that's existing as an attachment in another email, you would have to go through the rigmarole of opening the email, go to the print window, save it as a PDF as that destination, download it, and then drag that file into your new email as the attachment. Now, with this new feature, we can add existing emails as attachments very quickly and easily without downloading them first. So let me walk you through a couple of different scenarios. So first off, I've got this email up at the very top and I want to send this off to someone. Way number one that I can do it is select it. I can click my three-dot menu in the upper middle of our screen. And then down at the bottom, you'll see forward as an attachment. Pop that window up and you'll see down at the bottom, it has already added that as an EML file. And I can send it off as an attachment that way, as opposed to maybe just forwarding it. Now, another option that I have is I can actually select maybe multiple emails. And let me just grab a couple of emails here. Go to our compose window, and I can actually take these three and drag and drop them into our new email compose box. And it adds those three emails as attachments to this new email. So that's another way that we can do it. Now, if you are inside of an email, and let's say, for example, I've got this one that is a thread. I can go into my email that has multiple emails to it as a conversation thread. And let's say there's this one from Anson that I would like to add another email attachment to. Now, you'll notice that with this one, I need to reply. So if I go to my reply button, I don't see my list of emails to be able to drag that attachment to it. So here's what you'll have to do. You'll go to the upper right of that compose box in the reply. Pop it out into a separate piece. You'll see it will contain that old email. And down at the bottom, if you wanted to see what else was there, you could click on that trimmed content button. Now I can go back to my inbox view, find the email that maybe I want to add as an attachment, and drag and drop it to that email that's in the middle of a thread, and do it that way. Now, another thing that you may want to do is maybe you have an email, you're opened it, you're reading it, and we need to reply. I need to add an attachment email here. Once again, with the same piece, being that we're inside of the email, you'll need to go to the upper right of that box and pop it out. Then go back to your inbox or whatever label view you may have that email. Then you can find that particular email message you would like and drag and drop it in there, just like you would any other attachment from your hard drive. So those are a few different ways that you can add your emails as attachments to new emails, whether they're replies or whether they're brand new. Now, just a couple of heads up here. First off, I've just received an update from Google that they are adjusting the rollout for this feature for scheduled release domains. That rollout will now begin on the week of January 13th, 2020. So just be aware of that if you are on that scheduled release domain. If you are on a rapid release domain, or if you are working with your free Gmail account that you have, you can probably do that right now. It's immediately available. So just be aware of that. Just a quick thing if you want to do to double check whether it's available for you or not. Select an email, go to the top middle, three dot icon, and see if in that menu have forward as an attachment as an option. Now, being that this is a screen view of something as an update to your interface, if you don't immediately see it, what I would advise you to do is in your Chrome menu, click the three dot icon in the upper right corner of your screen, go down to More Tools in that Chrome menu and clear your cookies and cache with that Clear Browsing Data option. That will give your screen a reset for anything that would be brand new interface. And being that we're looking for that menu change, you may need to do that to have that change go into effect. Okay, so with that, everyone, I hope you all have a wonderful holiday season, no matter what you're celebrating this year around. Take care of each other, and have a wonderful new year. Until we meet again, everyone, this is Gary the Google Guy, signing off until another day, another time, another update. Bye-bye now.